Dear student, in today's lecture, we start a new article, Excess Pressure Across the Free Surface of Liquid, from chapter number 2, Mechanical Properties of Fluid. The point number 1, plane liquid surface. You can see a diagram of plane liquid surface. So two points A and B you can see very clearly. The point A is above the plane surface and point B is below the liquid surface. In this case, the resultant force due to surface tension on molecule B is zero. The force FA itself decides the pressure, and the pressure at A and B is same. So pressure at point A and pressure at point B is same. The simple conclusion of this is pressure above and below plane surface of liquid is same. Now part 2, convex liquid surface. You can see a diagram of convex liquid surface. Again, two points, A above the surface and B below the surface. Now in this case, resultant force due to surface tension FT at molecule B is vertically downward. So you can see here this FT, it is vertically downward. And add up to the downward force FA. This FA is also in downward direction. This develops greater pressure at point P, at point B. So both FA and FT, they are in downward direction. So greater pressure at point B. And the point B is on concave side. So you can see here this point B is on the concave side. Therefore, pressure on the concave side is greater than the convex side. So pressure at B greater than pressure at point A. Now third point, concave liquid surface. You can see diagram of concave liquid surface. Again, two point A and B we consider. Now in this case, force due to surface tension FT. You can see here FT, which is in upward direction. The force FA due to atmospheric pressure is downward direction. So FA and FT, they are in opposite direction. Therefore, the net downward force responsible for pressure at point B. Net downward force responsible for pressure. At B, the pressure is less. At B is, means at B is less than the FA. So you can say that here, this develops the lesser pressure at point B. Means at point B, the pressure is lesser. So here, less pressure at point B as compared to the point A. So therefore, again, the conclusion is pressure on concave side. Pressure on concave side is greater. Pressure on concave side is greater than the convex side. Therefore, here pressure at A is greater than the pressure at B. Now, next article is explanation of formation of drop and bubble. So, liquid drop and small bubbles are spherical in shape because of force of surface tension. The reason for the spherical shape is surface tension. And surface tension dominates the gravitational force. Another force acting on the liquid drop is gravitational force. But surface tension is the dominant force in that case. And because of that, because of surface tension, liquid try to minimize the surface area of the liquid. A bubble or drop does not collapse because of resultant of external pressure, and the force of surface tension is smaller than the pressure inside the bubble or inside a liquid drop. Now we have to learn new derivation. Excess pressure inside a liquid drop. So derivation. Now let me start this derivation. Consider a spherical drop. Now let I consider PI, pressure inside the drop, PO, pressure outside the drop. So you can see diagram here. In a diagram, PI and PO is shown. So small r is the radius of the drop. Let the radius of the drop increase from radius of the drop increase from r to r plus delta r, where delta r is very small, so that pressure inside the drop remains almost constant. Now let me find out the change in area in this case. So initial surface area of the drop is, it drop is spherical in shape, so area of sphere is 4 pi r square. So area, initial area we write by A1, so 4 pi r square, because initial radius you can see in a diagram it is r. Now final surface area of the drop, it is by A2, so A2 is equal to 4 pi into the final radius is r plus delta r in a bracket and its square. Now we find out, we expand this term and then we have to find out the increase in area. So here 4 pi, then we use here a plus b bracket square expansion. So we get r square plus 2r delta r plus delta r square. Now 4 pi multiplied by every term of the bracket. So we get 4 pi r square plus 8 pi r delta r plus 4 pi delta r square. So this is the final surface area. Now, in this, delta r is very small. If delta r is very small, so delta r square can be neglected. So we can write A2 is equal to, so we eliminate this term. So we get a final surface area of the drop is A2 is equal to 4 pi r square plus 8 pi r delta r. Thus, increase in the surface area of the drop is area 2 minus area 1. This is the increase in surface area. Now we substitute the area 2 and area 1, and after doing the subtraction, you can see this is the area 1 and this is area 2. So this 4 pi r square, this 4 pi r square get cancelled. So we get a2 minus a1 is equal to 8 pi r delta r. So this is the increase in area. Now work done in increase the surface area, we have to find out. So work done is equal to T into dA. Now T is the surface tension, dA is the increase in area. So T into increase in area is 8 pi r delta. So this is the equation number one. Also this work done is equal to, so work done is equal to force into displacement formula, everybody know that. So we expand the bubble with small factor delta. So work done is equal to F into delta. But the excess force is given by, so this F is the excess force. So we use the formula of the pressure and then we write the formula of the force is equal to pressure into area. So F is equal to, F is the excess force. So excess force is equal to excess pressure into surface area. So excess pressure in the case we can write PI minus PO. And the surface area is 4 pi r square. Hence, this formula of the excess force, we have to substitute in equation number 2. Then we get a formula of work done. So work done is equal to PI minus PO in a bracket multiplied by 4 pi r square delta. This is the equation number 3. Now, equating equation 1 and 3, we get. So this is equation 1. This is the work done. And this is equation 3. This is also work done. Both equation we have to equate. So we get T into 8 pi r delta r is equal to PI minus PO in a bracket multiplied by 4 pi r square delta r. Now we cancel the common term and then we write the equation for PI minus PO. This delta r get cancelled, pi get cancelled, this r, 1 r from r square get cancelled. Okay. And this 4 2's are 8. Okay, here in this side we get only 2t and in this side we get pi, means right side we get pi minus po in a bracket into r. So after writing formula of pi minus po, we get a formula for excess pressure inside the liquid drop, 2t by r. Now, this is called as Laplace law of spherical membrane. In case of soap bubble, same formula if you want to write for soap bubble. So soap bubble having a two free surfaces. So we can write here the formula. Same formula, this formula only multiplied by 2. So here we get 4t by r. So this is the formula for soap bubble. Now next article is capillary action. Now what is capillary action? It is also called as capillarity. So it is phenomena of rise or fall of liquid inside a capillary tube when it is dipped in a liquid is called capillarity or capillary action. Rise or fall. You remember this is or. You are not allowed to write and. Because for a liquid, you either observe rise or fall only. Capillarity is in action when? Means the application of the capillarity we have to see. Some example basically. So oil rises up the wick of lamp. It is because of capillarity. Cloth, rag sucks water. It is because of capillarity. Water rises up the crevices in rocks. It is because of capillarity. Sap and water rise up to the topmost leaves in tree due to capillarity. Blotting paper absorbs ink because of the capillarity. Many applications of the capillarity we can write. So these are the applications or uses of capillary action. Now, let me explain this, why liquid rise or liquid fall we observe. So first we explain capillary fall. So generally capillary fall is observed in case of mercury. So when we dip a capillary tube in a mercury, so you can see this diagram, this is the first case. So when we dip, we observe this type of structure. Then after some time, this level is fall. So this is before drop in level. As we insert the capillary, we can see this. And then liquid level fall and we get this type of picture. This is second picture. Okay. Now, so here we have to use the two conclusions to explain this capillary fall. The first conclusion is pressure on concave side is greater than the convex. Okay. And the second is pressure above and below plane surface is same. Now pay attention, when we are treating this two points C and D, so we are considering that much portion only. Now C and D, so this is the plane surface. So C and D are the points above and below the plane surface. So pressure at C and pressure at D is same. Okay. Now A and B, the two points. Okay. You can see here A on convex side and B on concave side. So I hope you remember this diagram, because by using this, we have to write the relation regarding the pressures. Now pressure on concave side is always greater than that on convex side. So we can write pressure at B greater than pressure at A, because B is at concave side. So equation number one we get. Now you know that pressure above and below the plane surface is same. So pressure at A is equal to pressure at C. A and C, these two points are the point in atmospheric pressure. Both the points are in air. So pressure at A and pressure at C same, because they are in air and the pressure is equal to the atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure. Now, between the point C and D, now here C and D are the point above and below plane surface. So we can write pressure at C is equal to pressure at D. Pressure at C is equal to pressure at D. But you know that pressure at C and pressure at A is same. So we use this here. So is equal to I written here the pressure at A. So we get the relation number 2, pressure at C is equal to pressure at D is equal to pressure at A. So hence by equation 1 and 2, let me use the equation 1 and 2, these two equations we use. Then this pressure at B as it is here. So instead of A we have written B. You can see here pressure at A and D both are same. So we have written pressure at D. So pressure by equation 1 and 2 we get pressure at B greater than the pressure at B greater than the pressure at D. But point B and D are at same horizontal level. Means pressure at B and D must be same. Must be same. So thus, in order to maintain this same pressure here, liquid level fall in a capillary tube. So liquid level fall in a capillary tube. So this is the explanation for fall of the liquid level. Now similarly, we have to learn explanation for capillary rise. Now you can see two diagrams here. As we just immerse the capillary tube, we can see this type of picture. Then after some time, we observe that the liquid level rises in a capillary tube and we get this type of picture after the water rises. Now again here the same pressure relations we have to use. PA, PB, PC, pressure at A, B, C, D respectively. Pressure on concave side is always greater. So pressure at concave side is always greater. So pressure at A is greater than B. Because you can see here the pressure on concave side is greater. So point A is on the concave side. So pressure is greater at A. As the point A and C, they are at same level in the atmosphere. So you can see here, this is A, this is C. They are at same level. So pressure at A and C must be same. This article is similar to the previous one. You can see the equations also near about similar. So few basic changes are there. You can compare both the article later on. So pressure at A and pressure at C, both are same. Between C and D. C and D are the point above and below the plane surface. So pressure is same. So pressure at C and D same. And you know that pressure at D equal to pressure at A. So pressure at C is equal to pressure at D is equal to pressure at A. By using this relation here. So we get equation number 2. Now by using equation 1 and 2, we have to write pressure at D greater than the pressure at D. You can see here this part we have written as it is here. But instead of pressure at A, we use pressure at D because pressure at A and pressure at D both are same. But you can see here this point D and this point B, both are at same level in a liquid. So pressure must be same. But what we get here? Pressure at D greater as compared to B. Means pressure at point B is less. But the pressure must be same. So to maintain same pressure, liquid rises in a capillary tube. Because pressure at B is lesser by this equation. So to maintain the same pressure, the pressure at B must be increased. Now how we can increase this? By increasing the level of the liquid. So as the level of the liquid increases, the pressure at B and D same. So as liquid start increasing its level, when the pressure at B and D same, then it stops. So this is the explanation of the capillary rise, which is similar to the previous explanation that you remember. Now we have to start new article expression for capillary rise or fall by using the first method, using pressure difference method. The pressure due to the liquid column at of height h must be equal to the pressure difference 2t by r. We learn the formula of pressure, excess pressure 2t by r. That formula we have to use. So here h rho g is equal to 2t by r. So rho is the density in this formula, g is acceleration due to gravity. Okay, and this is the diagram for force acting at the point of contact. Now this angle is the angle of contact, and by geometry this angle is also theta. So this is the capital R, and this is the small r is the radius of capillarity. Let small r is the radius of capillary tube, theta is the angle of contact. So that you can see in a diagram. So radius of curvature, R, capital R, of the meniscus is given by. So we can use a formula of cos theta. So cos theta is equal to small r by capital R. So capital R is equal to small r by cos theta. So this is the formula of radius of curvature, and this formula we can substitute in this equation. So this equation is, we get h rho g is equal to 2t divided by this capital R. Instead of this capital R, we have to write this. So we get the equation by substituting this. H rho g is equal to 2t cos theta by R. So this is the equation after substitution of capital R. Then we can write the formula of h by transferring this rho and g to the right side. So we get the formula for capillary rise. By this experiment, by this formula, we can find out the rise in the level of liquid in a capillary tube. Now, same article we have to learn by the method 2, by using forces. Rise of water inside capillary is against the gravity. Hence, the weight is balanced by the upward component of the surface tension. You can see a smaller portion of the capillary tube. Now here, as the liquid rises in a capillary tube, the weight of the liquid column is balanced by the upward component of the surface tension. Then only liquid attain this equilibrium stage. So we can write here, weight of the liquid column is equal to component of the surface tension. So weight is given by formula mg. And the component of the surface tension is Ft into cos theta. This is the formula. Now, we can write mass in term of density. You know that density is mass upon volume. So, mass is equal to density into volume. You can see here, instead of mass, we have written density into volume and g as it is. Now, this Ft. So, this component of the surface tension, the force due to surface tension in short, you know that surface tension is force by length. So F is equal to TL. So here T multiplied by L is here, it is circular in shape. So length of the circle is 2 pi R. So T into 2 pi R you can see instead of FT. And then cos theta as it is. Then, so rho as it is. Then instead of volume, we substitute this. So volume of the liquid column is area multiplied by height. So area is pi r square, height is h. So here instead of volume, we substitute this g as it is. And this right hand side as it is. Now here we have to cancel the common term. So what we cancel, we can cancel this pi. This r and 1 r from r square get cancelled. So we get here rho r h g is equal to 2t cos theta. And by using this expression, we can write formula of the capillary rise, and it is h is equal to 2t cos theta upon r rho g, which is similar to the previous formula. The same formula we obtain in the method 1 and method 2. This formula of the capillary rise you can write for the surface tension also. So we get surface tension is equal to h r rho g upon 2t cos theta. Today we stop here. In next lecture, we have to continue fluid in motion. So new article, which is other than the surface tension article.